And here we are on Antigua Shipyard, and in the upper right-hand corner of the map, we have our Red Zerg player from TSL. He's trying to come back and break the tie in his favor. It is Hyun, and his opponent, one of the very best Zerg players in the world, a master of ZBZ. From Star Tail, it's our purple Zerg player, Life.
Ladies and gentlemen, cross positions, a macro-oriented style of game. Or will it be? Everybody's been seeming to do early pools.
Okay, so we're at 10 supply now
here
for Life.
Overload.
Uh-oh.
I just did a clap. I didn't even want to. Yeah, I did.
We may even have a 13 pool out of these guys here in a bit. Wow. The latest we've actually had a first pool thrown down is 12 supply so far, and that was actually in game number one, and that was a big speedling all-in from Life. Didn't work out, though. Hyun was able to rally back, took the advantage there, and there it is, 13 supply apiece. We are going to have a normal ZBZ.
All right. So Hyun, I mean, can he go for a hatchery first? Like, can you honestly do that?
On this map, it's actually a little bit rougher than people realize. Some players have, but the walk distance is shorter than you think. And the other problem is that if you look at the opening that's right here, it's actually quite large. Add on top of that that there's so much staging area before you actually make it to the hatchery that it's very easy to sneak units up here and do some sort of a surprise attack. Looks like Life is actually going to go hatch first for the first time. Hyun is not.
Wait some time to do it, but this is, I mean, a pretty good strategically. He's like, does a lot of the hatcher, or does a lot of the spawning pool rushes, decides, all right, this time I'm going to 15 pool, then goes back to another cheese, and now is, yeah, he's really mixing it up. It's completely sporadic, unpredictable, and what, I mean, against a player that you respect, you know, because a player, if you can really manipulate the way they think, that is obviously the ideal scenario. Say, if you were to pit me up against, in a best of nine against a pro player, I mean, they'd probably just toy with me and know what I was going to do every game.
Sure.
But in a situation like this, it's pretty difficult to really play with and manipulate the way that your opponent is going to act. So just being completely unpredictable is extremely good. So Hyun, now discovering what Life is up to, sees the hatchery first, sees the gas, sees the pool.
Yeah, it was actually a 15 hatch, 16 gas, 16 pool, so quite late on all those, but making sure he still gets his Zergling speed intact when he wants it. Hyun decided to go for a little bit earlier pool before gas, I guess I should say, and is powering ahead, making sure he gets both queens up at the same time before moving into anything else.
A nice level of relative greed coming out of Life, in all honesty. You know, he's going to get the quick speed. Mm-hmm. He would have had a very difficult time getting out Lings if he had been up against a 10 pool.
Very true.
And it seems to be really the last thing he expected. So finally, a player going for a play to kind of counter what they expect their opponent to do and proving successful at it. Life going to... Well, he's actually going for a really quick Baneling Nest here. Now, he does only have one on gas, so it looks as if this is these are just going to be defensive Banelings. You know, one really... I mean, what are you going to make? One, two Banelings...
And when you go hatch first, you've got to get defensive Banelings. I mean, there's unless you're Nesty and you just want to try and go right to Roaches, but that doesn't work out for
anyone. Or just go straight drones.
Yeah, exactly. that's just what Nesty does. He just 200 drone rush and he wins. Is that a rush? I don't think that's considered a rush anymore. But let's see here. As Baneling Nest coming up, you've got to have the defensive Baneling Nest. It did come up a little bit earlier than you would expect, but it's still going to keep him plenty safe against any sort of a follow-up from Hyun.
It's a rush.
Yeah.
It took me a minute to decide, but Nest T actually kills you because of drones, so because of that.
Exactly.
With him, it's a rush. Only with Nest T, though.
And I'm sure there's someone out there who took that literally, who's like, you don't actually rush with 200. No, of course you don't. Stupid pretend person who's yelling at me. Anyway, I have arguments with imaginary people from time to time.
You're genuinely angry at this imaginary person.
I am.
Infuriated. I see you look really red.
Well, here comes the Baneling train, and a couple of the queens up at the front. They have to delay for a little bit here to make sure the Zerglings get in position. Four Banelings finishing up for Hyun at the same time, though. Banelings actually being shot down one at a time. Those Banelings are going to do very little. A couple of Banelings dying for Hyun in addition, but will he have enough here to hold this off? He kills a few Lings with that, and that's actually pretty good, but he's got to get more up stats. Otherwise, these Lings will actually ravage this drone line.
Yeah, he's picking off one drone, now going to engage with the Lings for just a second, decides to retreat out as Hyun. Does give up pursuit just for the moment, trying to circle back around outside of the vision of his opponent, but does not manage to sneak in. And Life at this point got almost nothing whatsoever done. I think he picked off one, maybe two drones.
Two,
and that's about it. So looks like it is going to be Hyun's turn to get aggressive. Life does have the Baneling nest and is now pulling in a significant amount of gas, but...
And he's got a few Banelings on his side of the map, too, and just finishing up that Spine Crawler. First few units are starting to roll in for Hyun, though, and he's going to try and test the waters right away. Loses a loses four Zerglings to one Baneling there. Another five Zerglings going down to another Baneling. So thus far, Life has actually been very, very cost-efficient with his units here, and he's picking off these Banelings one at a time. Really well done.
This is extremely impressive. Life finally just deciding, or excuse me, Hyun, just detonating those Banelings on the Queens because he was finding no success with them whatsoever. And Life holding off that push incredibly cost efficiently, guys. Cannot emphasize how beautiful of a hold that was.
Yeah, that was remarkable. I mean, his control was just on point. Take a look at the resources lost already at this early stage in the game. Hyun's lost about 50% more resources than he has, so congratulations. Life holding that off magnificently. He himself is going to aspire. We mentioned that Life likes using Mutalisks. I promise you that that's the case. And now we're actually going to see it for the first time.
You know how everything really did seem different this game for Life as well. I mean, besides just the 15 hatch going for the quick speed, playing very greedy-esque. And I wonder if that, you know, I mean, if it's a little bit of a predicator for Life's, when he decides to go for Muta, you know, he's going to have a really greedy early game, which does make sense, honestly. If you try to go for Muta when you're even the slightest bit behind, you can lose so easily. If your opponent goes Muta, it's just like, oh, you have more Mutalists than I do. I lose.
And if you're wondering how Muta's play goes, you still get to Roach and Fester at the end. The Mutas are not designed to kill your opponent. What they're designed to do is pick off a third base, keep your opponent pinned in, pick off drones, pick off overlords, and establish map control.
Wow.
And then move up. Oh, just, well, that's amazing. You only lost four Zerglings and two Banelings there. So once again, great control. And then your damage is done through speedling counterattacks, which deny bases, and then you eventually just get yourself up to the normal Roach Infester count, which will be theoretically much, much higher than your opponent's if you really dedicate yourself to it.
Really, really good points there out of the Mutas. But Life, you know, he's actually really good at just using Lings to deny thirds.
Yes, he is.
So he's going to get started with this. This, of course, will allow the Mutalist to more easily clean this up, but ultimately is not going to be able to get too much damage done. Going to try to sneak some Banelings into the line. The Roach is not able to do it, but that Spine Crawler going to finish off at least one of those Banelings. The other one will make it into the mineral line. Damages four drones.
Yeah, does a little bit of damage there, but not enough to kill him. There needs to be a pretty big upgrade disparity. A plus two weapons to zero Carapace upgrade advantage to be able to kill things in just one go. And the first few Mutalists are working their way out. Have they picked off any Overlords yet? Let me see if any of these guys have. I don't think so, but now they're going to do exactly what they were designed to do. And no, I don't want to select Automaton. Like, it just randomly...
I was surprised he wasn't dead.
Yeah.
Those Mutaglaive Worms, man, they are...
vicious.
Bouncy.
Okay, this is a potential of a lot of dead roaches here. Of course, the DPS from Mutalisk is very low, and so it takes them about a year and a half to kill a roach. But, you know, roaches can't shoot up, so eventually the Mutas will still win in the end. It's just how much damage can you do to them before the rest of your defenses get in position.
Well, the roaches are going to opt to try to do some damage to this third of Life, but, I mean, even with the addition of a couple, there we go, see some roaches and a queen coming now. I mean, the hatchery shouldn't fall as long as roaches, Lings, something arrive. Here's some Lings to distract from the roaches shooting the hatchery in the meantime, and that'll do it. So Life now at 100 supply, 65, jumping up to 77 for a moment, is Hyun as he's popping out another seven roaches. He's finally got Pathogen Glance. It's at 30 seconds. He could start those Infestors right now, but instead he makes another queen. So there we go. Infestors starting up, and, you know, that's what he needs to be able to truly... remove the fear that these Mutalisks are putting on the field.
All right, well, the Mutalisks run smack dab into a queen and two Spore Crawlers there. So can't do too much, but it was a very timely queen that actually pops up there. Five Infestors, as you mentioned, to try and strike fear into the heart of Mutalisks everywhere are about to hit the field. But, you know, Life himself going up to, let's see, that's a macro hatch. He's already got a third base in play, and it's already pretty well saturated. He's still up by 21 supply. He's up by 29 workers. So he's got a significant economic advantage.
Muta's going to be circling around to the left-hand side, catching an overseer. And I got to say, Kevin, it weirded me out for a second hearing you say Life himself. I was like, wait, isn't it Life itself? wait.
Yes. Life. Life can be harsh sometimes.
Swinging around to this third, though. And this is where it's been vulnerable. The Mutas have really... Ooh, nice spread there. The Mutas have really had an opportunity to come into this third because there's only been one Spore Crawler there. But now, with the Infestors on the field, as we were talking about earlier, strikes fear into the Hearts? Hearts?
I mean, we have like nothing cows? To they fear, have hearts? But Infestas themselves. What's up? Sorry.
Cows. They have. Oh, no. Oh, wow. They have stomachs. Never mind.
Yes.
I don't know what I'm saying. Is
lots.
There, there's an animal that has multiple hearts.
Yeah. I don't know. They have you lots of stomachs. I don't know.
Tweet
about
at us.
I don't know about
let
the,
us know.
The multiple hearts.
Something has multiple hearts.
Do you know of an animal that has multiple hearts? Well, we want to hear from you here at the IPL. I don't know why I did like bad 30
announcer
voice. That was
a crazy
there,
accent.
Yes. Anyway, so Queen is going to bite the dust. Fortunately, the two sport crawlers have jumped up to the top, and that does leave a lot of drones exposed. Looks like the units would be able to react in time, though, and life has to get away. Yeah. But he's still winning this delay game. He's taking the map. He's making sure that he has all of his units in position.
He's being active with the mutas in the meantime, forcing Hyun to think about other things than catching up. You know, in that position, really abusing the fact that, oh, your infestors are a little bit forward at the bottom of this, at the central area. Let me fly in your main. Oh, my goodness, you moved your sport crawlers. It couldn't be any better. Let me pick off your queen and run away. I mean, Life, now he's getting into the mineral line. Unit's out of position once again. He's killing tons of drones. And it's just, you know, eventually these mutas are worthless, so why not get things done with them now? And that's exactly what he's doing. Life doing a fantastic job. It's no surprise at all, Kevin.
Yeah.
You were saying earlier, he goes for muta play off on a frequent basis because he's doing a fantastic job with these, even though Hyun has the tools to stop him.
And killing yet more drones inside of the natural. So he just continues to do damage at every turn. He's still up by 19 workers, but of course, you know, his opponent has had to basically reproduce those the entire time because he's been at such a disadvantage. And even if you take the amount of workers out of the equation, there's still a significant army advantage for Life overall. He's on +2 upgrades. He's going up to +1 carapace. His opponent is still nowhere close to being finished with +2 ranged weapons. So there's a significant opportunity for Life to move in, and that's exactly what he's going to do right now.
Moving forward with all of these units, letting them stream quite a bit. As the roaches got on that creep, they really took off ahead of the rest of the army, but Hyun not catching anything there. Going to catch the queen, in fact, is Life. Moving forward with all of his units now, and you know, it's 200 supply to 140. Oh, wow. Just baits all of the infested Terrans and then says, I'll see you in 30 seconds.
Yep, and that's exactly what he's going to do. He just goes over the destructible debris. He fungles and pins down a few units up at the top. Gets a, I think he a little bit carelessly gets a couple of units caught out of position there. But it's still not really going to matter all that much. He's able to pretty efficiently go through all the infested Terrans. Like you mentioned before, there's not that much energy that's remaining on most of the infestors. A couple of those did just pop out or did just rejoin the army, I should say. One or two of them were actually sitting in defensive mutas.
Well, here we go. 200 supply, 260. Very much of Hyun's energy has been expended. And Life's actually going to get in a really, really nice position. If he can get all of his units up here, nice fungal growth does catch a good portion of the roaches, but overall, no, the concave for Life is so good right now. Infested Terrans are going to go down and get a lot of damage out. Actually, the Infested Terrans are eating up a ton of hits right now from these Hydras and will push Life back for the moment. 187 to 150, so the supply has stayed relatively the same spread. But here's the thing. Life is on 4 bases. Hyun is on just 3, almost mined out in his main as well. So Hyun does not have the sustain that Life has at this stage of the game.
And we can see this now in the production because there's only eight roaches out for Hyun, 27 out for Life at the moment. He still even has those Hydras, those Metalus up at the top that he could
those
move back
very
in and pick
buoyant
off.
Buoyant Hydra.
Yeah, I know. Just kind of flying through the air, you know. Heart of the Swarm upgrade. No. You know, he can move in and pick off a couple of infestors at a time. He's certainly going to force a cancel here on this hatchery. And Hyun still pinned back, but he's managed to amass quite an impressive army. The advantage is still definitely Life's. He's on 4 bases. He's got superior economy. He's got defenses everywhere. He's got the more, I mean, not just a bigger army, but a more well-rounded army.
Yep.
But Hyun, once again, showing his resilience in these kind of long, drawn-out games.
Well, Hyun at this point has almost maxed out once again. Life giving him a great opportunity in that regard, but I mean, you look at the consequences that are associated with giving him time, and honestly, I mean, Life is taking complete and utter map control. I think he's just going to play an extremely defensive game, really take over the map. Now, he's got these spine crawlers out in the middle, so any engagement for Hyun is going to be quite difficult. Now, Hyun is circling around, as we see here with these Burrowed Infestors, to try to get something done. Burrowed Infestors are really, 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 they're like the Dark Templar for Zerg.
Yeah,
which is
basically
a fantastic comeback mechanism.
Well, we'll see if he can, excuse me, get all the infested Terrans down here that he wants, bypassing an infester of his opponents while he gets most of his units in position here in the top left-hand corner. There's the infested Terrans, and I don't know if Jan knows about this yet, but he will here momentarily as his drones are starting to disappear very quickly.
At the same time, attack moving in through the middle of the map. Spinecrawlers in position are going to do a nice amount of damage here, but overall, Hyun with the much better concave for the moment. Remember, though, life has been in the better position. Look at the supplies dropping for both players pretty substantially. Lots of infested Terrans going down pretty much everywhere.
Yeah, and Hyun, you see the inability to reproduce at the moment on fewer bases. Look at the larvae banked for life. He had 39 larvae available, turns him immediately into 39 roaches. So even though a little bit of a draw there in the middle, even though the armies basically fought themselves down to zero units apiece, because of the fact that he can get another 40 roaches out there, life still has a significant advantage in this game.
Yeah, I mean, being able to hold that off was really all he needed to do. And it was a very even engagement overall, as we were saying. Hyun had that really nice concave at the top. I'm not actually sure the upgrades on both players. 2-2 for both?
I believe so, yeah. So. Well, no, actually, maybe just 2-1 for... Yeah, actually, just okay. Plus one Carapace.
So, I mean, the concave that he had really saved him for that moment, but now we're at a position where life on four bases versus Hyun on three. Life is going to push with this gigantic counterattack, guys, and maybe finally take the lead for the first time in this series in Hyun Fight Club versus the man himself, TSL Hyun. Here we go. Final units going down as the Roaches and Infested Terrans pick apart the last vestiges of a hope for TSL Hyun here in Game 7.
GG, and StarTail Life becomes the first player in IPL Fight Club history to take more than three games against TSL Hyun. Hyun is actually one game away from being eliminated here in this set.
Guys, don't go anywhere. We are just getting started at seeing maybe Hyun finally get taken out. I don't know. It doesn't make sense.
That's not intelligible. Start speaking English, please, if you want to continue casting here. No, I'm sorry. All right, guys, that is it for game number 7. Game number 8 is going to be on Metropolis. We're going to run to a commercial break. When we come back, we're going to see if Hyun can tie things up or if he's going to be eliminated and life can actually win $1,600.